Hi, I'm Christine Morris, Chief Resilience Officer for the City of Norfolk. Thank you so much for taking your time today to give us input on this transformational project.
The red lines represent the project area in the Chesterfield Heights and Grandy Village neighborhoods on the eastern branch of the Elizabeth River. The blue lines show how the water drains through these neighborhoods into the river. Chesterfield Heights and Grandy Village flood for two reasons. The water is rising in the Elizabeth River and blocking the storm drains during high tides. Heavy, more frequent storms overflow the stormwater system. Flooding is worse when the tide is high.
To fix this, we have worked with the community to select a number of options, including living shorelines and marshes to reduce shoreline erosion, berms and flood walls to keep the water in the river and off the land, and wetland areas, creeks, and rain gardens to store rainwater where it falls. This picture is so much more than figuring out what to do about flooding. As part of our resilience strategy, we want to make sure that open spaces are great places for the community to use. This picture shows how the park near Grandy Village is designed to provide protection, to connect people, and to engage residents. The green areas show the path of the protected berm. The pink arrows show how paths will connect areas of the park. The blue areas show stormwater management features. We have designed a number of spaces based on how residents said they want to use the park. As you can see in this picture, there are five district areas designed around the main water management features of the berm and retention areas. Let's take a closer look at each area. The Academy grounds near Chesterfield Academy School provide outdoor learning spaces, community garden areas, playgrounds, and courts, primarily for the use of Chesterfield Academy students. The community terrace has areas for people to gather, to relax, play, eat, and chat. The hillside play area has nature-focused play spaces and more traditional play courts. Finally, the Wild Wetland Walk contains an ecopath with hands-on experiences of the tidal history of the area. Let us know what you think of the park design. We are still working to design other green areas, including a fishing pier and stormwater park. We will be back to show you those designs soon.
Thank you again for your time, and we look forward to working with you on this transformational project.